whatever they've been learning, whatever they've been doing. I'm sure there's a lot individually that we have a lot to share. There is a more button on the right-hand side of the screens. If you press that, there's a chat. You can pick it down as comments as you want out there. Everybody, and I repeat, everybody other than the speakers should be on mute. You may or may not disengage your camera. There is a mute button, but that mute button has to definitely be on. And after the speaker, what we're going to have is immediately after this, Nayan is going to take over your question. After that, we will have the entire flow. At the end of it, we're going to keep about half an hour for you to ask your questions, which will be taken from the chat and shared to us by Pritham. Pritham will choose who to pose the questions to. Now, with that, Nayan, I'll get over to you and I go on mute.
Right. Hi, everybody. So, today's flow, the way we are going to go ahead is, number one, we will start with Mr. Joseph. Mr. Joseph talking to us about what work CREDAI-MCHI has done helping, assisting the state government, the municipal corporation for fighting this COVID-19. Thereafter, Mr. Pritham will take over and he will explain to us that in the last 12 days, everybody has been active in the MCHI committee regarding and explain that what are the various representations that we have done to RBI, to the finance ministry, to the banks, RERA, etc. And he will take us through for that. And thereafter, I'll be speaking for a few minutes. And thereafter, it will be Deepak who will speak. And thereafter, it will be Boman. So each of us will speak for about 5 to 7 minutes. And then we have left about half an hour for question answers. Okay? So over to Joseph to start.
Hello everyone, my name is Joseph. The activities carried out by CREDAI-MCHI for Government of Maharashtra for COVID-19. So what we did is we got a call, this was exactly 3 weeks back, and we were given the work of making the entire creative. So if you see the entire city is painted red and blue. So there were two agencies appointed by the Government of Maharashtra. One was Lintas and second was MCHI. So all the creatives, what you see in red is done by Lintas, and what you see in blue is done by MCHI. Then what we did is there were 1,200 hoardings across Mumbai. Then then we did a 400 revised quarantine creative hoarding in Mumbai. This was all sponsored by our developers. There's Rustamji, Nahar, Ajmera, Oberoi's and Romel. These are the creatives, what we did. These are the hoardings. This is across Mumbai. If you see an entire, this is painted blue and red by us. Busbacks, trains. This is the revised hoarding, revised creative of home quarantine. This is very interesting. We provide PPE kit. This is a personal protective kit. This was not available in the market. We got this kit specially from Kerala Trivandrum. And this kit was so expensive. It was in the black market. People were hoarding it. But still we got, and we arranged around 4,000 kit from Kerala. And this was sponsored by Romel Group, Ajmera Realty, Rustamji, and Haptown. So the cost of the entire kit was around 50 lakh rupees. And this kit, by the way, this kit is approved and certified by the doctors in Mumbai. Then a youth wing, Dawal Ajmera, Anand Mane, and Hussein Lata, they sponsored around 40,000 masks to Mumbai police. Setting up at a quarantine center at MCMCR Pawai. Satish, can you talk about this? Satish?
Okay, I think Satish is not there. I think
okay,
the
so
first...
I'll talk about it.
Sorry, I'm there.
Satish, please talk about
and
this,
there,
Pavai.
And there. Yeah, respected members, we are proud to say that MCMCR Pavai, the Research and Training Center, have been completely converted
Satish,
to
you
a
are not audible.
Have been completely converted to a quarantine center with 250 beds, with side tables, hospital equipments, CCTV, fire safety equipments, catering services, housekeeping, round the clock. So the members who have generated, who are contributed for this is Mayfair Housing and Wadhwa, 30 lakhs each. Oberoi contributed 20 lakhs. Modi Realty Spaces, 3.6 lakhs. Neelkanth, Rishabh Group and Veena Developers, 2 lakh each. We also have Rommel Group who have donated the office chairs and the wooden cupboards for this. We are proud to say currently there are 70 occupants already there using this benefits. One more thing, respected members, would like to say that all the donors would get a certificate from MCGM, the CER certificate under the CER scheme of MCGM. Thank you.
Next.
Yeah. Morning, everyone. My name is Pritam.
Well, it's not over. It's not over, Pritam. It's not over.
These are the glimpses for the photos of the center where you can see the medical staff over there. And this is the Raigad and the Navi Mumbai unit who are donating rations to all the needies in the Raigad and Navi Mumbai district over there. It's going on every day, even now.
This is very interesting. I am Joseph again. Yeah. This medicine is called hydroxyl medicine, a tablet. This was not available in Mumbai and Maharashtra. It was fortunately that my one of my best friend, he owns a pharmaceutical company, and he said he had a raw material to produce this tablet. So we spoke to Mr. Pardesi. We got a special permission to open his factory. His factory is in Bhiwandi, and we got a special permission for him, special letter of from BMC to MCHI and to this company AB Bioproducts. He manufactured 10,000 hydroxyl tablets and he supplied to all the hospitals in Mumbai. And this was appreciated by Mr. Pansi himself. And he said that in one of the chat that this medicine is working, hydroxyl medicine. And today in the newspaper, US is short of this medicine and they want to import from India. So this was all done by my friend and coordinated, facilitated by MCHI. Then next is we also did some creative things working from home. We launched our Housing for All logo. And we also did a stay home, stay safe video. This is the video. So this video is all about stay home, stay safe, and social distancing. Last but not the least, we have a procurement wing led by Nimesh Ajmera, Nilesh Puranik, and Akshay Agarwal. We started this webinar last Friday, that was 4th April, and we have this webinar every day. We will keep you posted on this procurement thing by me and by a team. Last but not the least, let me tell you all that MCHI, the entire MCHI team is working since last 3 weeks. We are working 16 to 18 hours, but fully tied up with all the work with Government of Maharashtra and Satish.
Unmute, Satish.
Welcome.
Yeah.
Hello. Yes. We in fact have also
webinar chalu thai gayu chave super
Continue, Joseph. We need to leave.
Satish, now you start with your the secretariat thing.
It's done. It's only the labor construction laborers have been getting food. You know, with the coordination with the government of Maharashtra Labor Department, we have you know, collected all the you know, data of laborers on the site of all the developers. We have shared all the details with the Labor Department, and the Labor Department have started providing midday meals in Thane district. In they have started also in Mumbai suburbs. It is going a bit slow because there were lack of staff for this, but they're increasing the capacity day by day. So by this week, I think everybody on the site would get the midday meals scheme activated properly. Thank you. Harish
has a bad network. So there Harish, can you come online? Satish, you continue.
Sir, I will request Preetam sir to please put some light on the representation that CREDAI-MCHI has done. Preetam sir, will you please take over the screen?
Yeah. Thank you, Drupti. Good morning to everyone. This time around, the crisis is not only a financial crisis, it's led by a health crisis. So the entire focus of everyone, including the government and the NGOs, is on ensuring that we contain the health crisis first before there is any hearing that we can get as a body for our financial issues. So if you've seen right from the Prime Minister to the Finance Minister and everyone, they've first spoken about how the containment and how people should get their essential supplies. So we have written to everyone, including the Prime Minister, the Chief Minister, the Municipal Commissioner and the RBI. With all our representations, there are some overlaps in all the representations that we have made. And thereby, I will only give you the key representations which affect us. The Municipal Commissioner, in all our units, they have a particular format given. They should write to their own commissioners about the waivers that we want. Otherwise, to the Chief Minister, the RBI and the Finance Minister, we are making a joint representation for all the units. Some of the key waivers that we've asked for. The first one is the declaration of the COVID-19 as a natural calamity, which the government of India itself has done it. Thereby, we are able to now ask for a force majeure clause to be brought into most of our contracts, along with our financial contracts, our contractual contracts with other contractors, vendors, so on and so forth. So each one of you has to look at it from a legal perspective and see what force majeure conditions can be brought in. Second, we have written to RERA and also to the Chief Minister about RERA, and that circular has just come in 2 days back, that we've got a waiver of 3 months for filing all our RERA-related information on the website, and all plans have been postponed by 3 months, suo moto by RERA. So that's a very good move by Maha RERA. State governments also to see that the other RERAs in other states also can follow the same. We have made certain representations to the UD Minister, the Principal Secretary UD, and the Municipal Commissioner. The first one is that we have asked them to reduce the ASR of developed land to about 33% of the land and building. So, a reduction of our premiums has been requested for. Deferment of all the premiums up to 30th of September has been requested from the state government as well as the Municipal Commissioner. We have asked for reduction of interest, no interest to be paid in the period in the next 3 months, like the RBI has given us. And later on, the balance interest to be paid over a period of 9 to 12 months. The same is the question with the tax. There should be no tax. The tax should be waived off between 15th and March to 30th of June. And the balance tax should be only 50% should be paid, and the rest should be collected in installments from 30th of September up to a period of 1 year. For most importantly, in the next 12 months is going to be finance and interest outgo. So we've sent a detailed letter to the RBI, the NHB, and to individual MDs of all the banks and NBFCs. We have sent about 85 letters to all the bank and the NBFC CEO MDs, which basically we have, at that point in time, the RBI had come up with a moratorium circular. So there was some confusion about whether it's applicable for people who were overdue before 1st of March or not. So we have clarified all of that. Subsequently, RBI has clarified that dues before 1st of March had to be paid and shall go as per the regular the NCLT norms. Dues between 1st of March and 31st of May have been given a moratorium period. So that was clarified. We have asked for from the RBI that no interest should be charged for a period of the lockdown period plus 30 days. It's a very big ask, but we nonetheless ask that because our cash flows, because our sites are shut, offices are shut, we won't be able to pay interest. So we have asked for that. No penal interest or default interest shall be charged during the period of 1st March to 31st of August 2020. So no extra costs should be levied by the banks and NBFCs. Another more very important and the most significant requirement that we have asked for the RBI and requested the bank MDs also to represent to RBI. We are also written to IBA and we are going to have a meeting with IBA. IBA is Indian Banking Association. It's a very powerful association of all the MDs of the banks, which influences the RBI in a big manner. We have requested for one-time restructuring to be allowed. We have given our reasons why we requested for one-time restructuring. Very importantly, if one-time restructuring comes, all that was asked for in the past will not be important because all of us require that one-time restructuring so that we can restructure the entire loan, the principal payment which are coming up in the next 12 months, the interest can be, moratorium can be given. The RBI is very loath to allow that, but we have at least requested that at least if nothing, the SWAMI fund, which has been set up by the Ministry of Finance, all cases which are taken up to be funded by SWAMI fund, at least should be given that one-time restructuring. The SWAMI fund themselves have represented that any case which comes to them should be allowed for one-time restructuring. That should be the biggest ask across the board from all units to everyone that we can influence, MPs, MLAs, anyone who can talk to the right people in the right corridors. We should ask for this one-time restructuring to be allowed. It was allowed in the 2008 financial crisis. At that time, India was not affected so badly, but then too they allowed it. This time, in fact, India is badly affected. There is a lockdown situation and thereby it's the bigger reason for them to allow a one-time restructuring. So if that is allowed, we will be, you know, really comforted. So that was what we have written to RBI. I think I've covered most of what we all requested all the banks to give moratorium for EMIs, interest in principal to all the shopping mall owners, the office owners, the hotel owners. We've asked for a 5% interest subsidy to be given to all new residential home loans in respect of apartments booked in the next 6 months. So we have given a very big ask. Obviously, these are all which is something which cannot be directly given by the state government or by the municipal commissioner or by the RBI. It's a mix of everything. But the ask has been sent out so that whatever we can get in the next 6 months will be helpful to our members across the board. That's about what we made. The plan of action is once the lockdown is lifted, all our senior members, including president, secretary, vice presidents, are going to be calling for individual meetings with CM, with principal secretary, UD, municipal commissioner, and RBI, IB. All these meetings face-to-face haven't happened. We've sent letters to them. We are requesting for face-to-face meetings to discuss these issues once the lockdown is completed or lifted. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pritam. I wish to put on record for the knowledge of all our members about the great work that our MCHI secretariat has done. As you can see that, you know, what we have done in the last 10-12 days, even when everything was working perfectly, you know, we were not able to achieve. So I must really compliment the entire secretariat for coming up to this wonderful occasion, point number one. Especially for the MCMCR, when the municipal commissioner called us up, the entire Powai building was except for the conference room, everything else, those rooms were not opened since the last 2 years. And the entire building was converted into a 250-bed isolation facility. And this was managed by Satish, Harish, Navashish, the purchase managers of a few people. And it was really done wonderfully well. And the Honorable Commissioner went on record to write to Times of India, to on his own Twitter handle, etc., to acknowledge everybody. Second, I want to acknowledge the great work done by Vimal, Dominic, Mayur, Dharmesh, Naveen Makhija, Pritam, and others for this various representation that you see. Nainesh, you will not believe that 21 drafts were prepared before the letters went to the RBI. And regarding RERA, the moment we spoke, we spoke to Gautam Chatterjee ji. Within a few hours, he came out with that notification about force majeure and all that. So thanks to everybody, and thanks to all the contributors, all the donors, who have risen to the occasion. Everybody has great liquidity issues, cash flow issues, but yet humanity prevailed over the personal pain that each one of us are passing through, and we require more PPE kits. That is the need for the day. So if some of you can please come forward and contact Dominic or contact Satish, then that will be really great. So this is the need. Having said that, I would like to say a few things to all of you. Number one, my message is, number one, stay positive. Stay positive. See, this is a kind of a once in a lifetime or once in a century's event that has come. If we are mentally fit, if we are physically fit, then we will be able to, come up and do everything that is required, we can turn around things, but it's very important that we all remain physically fit, mentally fit, we remain positive. That's point number one. Two, my belief is that as and when the lockdown opens, whether it is 15th of April or 30th of April, what day, I don't know. I feel prices will not fall. Prices will remain stable. Yes, it may happen that, our customers may take time to make payments to us, but we'll have to adjust to that. But prices, because as it is, all the prices of our apartments were at rock bottom. So there is no scope of the prices getting reduced any further. Point number four, I would like to say that please don't be in a kind of a situation where we go and tell our channel partners that I'm offering you 5%, 6%, 4%, any kind of crazy commissions to them, because that's going to, they will take undue advantage of it. You know how it works. So we all should be very clear that we will give them whatever is due to them, whatever the standard percentages we have, that is what we should be doing with them. And we need to see that, our families and everybody, each of us today, could be, I know, are living in kind of a fear, anxiety, depression, thinking, kal kya hoga, kal kya hoga, what will happen to my finances and stuff like that. But I feel that if we are able to keep ourselves positive, mentally fit, physically fit, keep the moral high in the family, not let us get into any depression of any sort of, then we all will be ready, to face this. And I want to assure each and every member that the entire CREDAI Managing Committee, the core committee, the leaders, our past presidents are solidly working as a single team, to see that each and every issue of ours is properly heard. Yesterday, we had a call with CREDAI National, and two things they have decided. Number one, that we are going to fight with the government that GST, which is at 5%, which is right now a composite scheme, but we will ask for GST at 5% with the setback option. So this is with the ITC, with the input tax credit. So this is what we are going to fight about, because the moment the composite schemes came, our cost of construction automatically went up by 18%. So So that is one thing that we are going to do. Second is that we are going to request the government of Maharashtra to reduce stamp duty up to 2% for a period of 3 to 4 months. Why 3 to 4 months? I'll tell you. The reason is that we want our flat customers who are sitting on the fence to come and buy apartments. If you make it 6 months, then he will say, okay, I'll think about buying the apartment after 3 months, 4 months. So we are going to request the government that for a period of 3 months or 4 months, you reduce the stamp duty just to 2% so that people buy. Because the RBI has solved the supply side by bringing 3,50,000 crores. But what about the demand side? So the demand side, we have not been able to get anything done. So these are the two things that CREDAI National and CREDAI Maharashtra is going to do, is GST at 5% with ITC and stamp duty at 2%. So these are the few things with which, you know, this will be our goal year in after. And now over to Deepak.
Thanks, Nayan. Good morning, friends. This is a really a challenging time which nobody in the world had imagined, that everyone in the world will have this sort of a situation. The underdeveloped country to developing country to advanced, most advanced country. This is something where nobody has a solution. We all need to fight our own battle. And we have been able to do to some level, thanks to our ministry in Delhi and all, we, and even our chief minister, both are quite proactive, and we are able to keep some numbers under control. We, to begin with, our real estate industry, MCHI, what we've been doing in Mumbai and MMR has been explained by the team. Along with that, something about the labor cess point of view, what we have been paying as a labor cess on each and every sanction and permission. There's a scheme of government of Maharashtra to provide Atal Food Yojana. In that they are providing a lunch to our laborers. They are providing lunch to the registered laborers. Developers not being aware about the scheme were not registering, and the facility which was available since last long time, since last more than a year or two, which was not being enjoyed. We in MCHI could able to persuade the government and labor commissioner that even non-registered laborers at various sites, they should provide us the food, at least lunch for the laborers. And we could able to get the numbers from all our members, and we have been able to gather almost 70,000 laborers at various sites in Mumbai, Thane, Navi Mumbai, Vasai Virar, and Raigarh. And around 1,200 sites with all this location, with 75,000 laborers working at different sites. And the food supply has started because there was an issue about the people running away, and then there was not able to manage the food. But gradually now foods are reaching to the sites. And we are expecting by this week, we should be able to get food at all the sites. If any issue is there, you can always definitely contact to the MCHI team, and we'll be able to help you to get the food for the laborers as a midday meal. Along with the midday meal, definitely workers are expecting some food for the dinner or the evening food, and all snacks for the breakfast. And all that, every developer are working on it, providing the ration to the customer or to our laborers. Government is providing only the lunch. Dinner and all is our obligation or responsibility, and which all developers are providing some rations and all to the workers, and they are able to stay and work on that. The thing is, once this thing's over, gets over, one need to register and take the benefit of the Labor Act of BOCW and take it further for the laborers. Along with the laborers, there are security staff which are there, housekeeping staff which are there at sites and all, which are also, we need to work with them to provide at least basic facilities and the food at least for them, that they should able to work in, properly at our sites, which is also our obligation to do, and every developer is working on it. So that's
Deepak, we can't hear you.
We can't hear you, sir.
Deepak. Deepak bhai, we can't hear you.
I think the mute button is on, Deepak bhai. No, his mute button is not on. Deepak, we cannot hear you. Can you hear
us? Trupti, can you?
So he's already unmuted. It is some technical issue at his end.
Okay, so okay, but while...
I think...
Deepak...
Okay, so while Deepak, reconnects himself or whatever, I would like to say a few points. Number one, everybody in the world has realized that real estate is the best investment. You know, stocks have crashed, mutual funds have crashed, everything has crashed by more than 50%, and they feel it is... Deepak, can you... Okay, you continue, then I'll take up the other issues. Yeah, sorry.
Sorry, friends. I think there was some issue with the volume, other things. Now are you able to hear us better?
Yeah. Yes. Great.
Shall I repeat? Because I don't notice.
We lost you at the point that the night food had to be provided.
Okay. So the thing is, along with the lunch, the other developer is trying to work on it, providing the ration to the workers for the night food and something for the breakfast and all. All the workers are being there at site, doing nothing. There is no income from them. Neither the contractor can able to afford the food and other ration for the workers. There are security staff, there are housekeeping staff other than the construction workers. All it's our obligation, and everybody is trying to work on it, and we need to take care at least basic requirement of the ration and the food, which we need to support there. Depend now this other issues, you know, that under the government's scheme, government has been able to looking at various payments and all. Right now, every developer is passing through the various issue of cash flow. Funds not available since the day we had a lockdown. Lockdown was there since 17th March onward in Maharashtra. And based on that, whatever the fund is available, limited fund, we need to continue for maybe 2 months or little more than that, or something which nobody knows things. So we need to work on it that basically labor services, utility services, housekeeping, security, and other basic requirement we need to provide for everyone. That is point of view, every developer is trying to work on their, based on their cash flow. Our president, Nayan Bhai, has explained about the market scenario and the challenges which everybody is facing. Lot of issues, uncertain answers, and questions are there which nobody has the right answers. So based, overall, if you see that the only way we look at it, we be positive. We all have, as a developer, have a various strength. We have been day in, day out, having a lot of challenge, doing the firefighting for various things. Market point of view, a lot of negative reports are coming in the media. Of course, the reports are coming that prices may correct to whatever the numbers they share, which as a developer, we have experienced last in 7-8 years, whatever the correction has happened to the great level. Now, it is at a bottom prices there. It is a right time, right opportunity for the customer to buy. When market will open, when things will start move, it is, of course, we need to see once after the opening of the lockdown thick, and may take a couple of months. But we need to be confident about ourselves. We need to be having a positive about ourselves. Prices is all-time low. Prices will not be corrected anything further. And we will be able to work on trying to sell in ongoing projects. New project launch and all is another issue, but at least ongoing project where we have a lot of commitment with our customers and all, we have to keep up with the cash flow and try to achieve whatever sales are able to achieve at the realistic price. I think I have covered. Now let Boman continue further.
Yeah. So before Boman comes, I want to clarify 2 points. Number one, we are going to have a campaign for real estate sahi hai. Real estate is the best investment. And it is proved. Everybody now knows ke mera ghar tha, to main safe tha. You know, so that is one thing that we are definitely going to take up. People have been asking about salaries. That what should we be doing about our salaries? Now, this is a very, very sensitive question, but I would like to address this particular issue for all of us. What personally, the way I have been thinking about is that we today, it is the issue of cash flow and survival. Our staff is like our family. You know, most of the developers have staff which have been working with them from 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, you know. They are like a family. I think what we need to do is to be very transparent with them. Talk our heart out, not our mind out. Talk our heart out to them. I know you are also in fear. Today, each and every employee, his wife, his sister, his children, all are under fear. So, we mere pati ka, meri ka, we all have to first reassure all of them positive. We are going to go ahead. And then, depending upon the case-to-case situation, there is no doubt that there could be a little hellback of salaries, deferment of salaries, staggering of salaries, but you have to love and you know, with all that in mind. So these two things I wanted to clarify. Boman, over to you.
Thank you, Nayan. Thank you, Deepak. Guys, very quickly, before we start off, I want to just say that you have to take great pride in the work that your chamber has been doing. I'm sure a lot of work is being done by all individually. I want you to actually put across, I mean, tabulate, compile, whatever work you all are doing and send it across the chamber, because this is the right time to even kind of express to the government that developers don't only come with a begging bowl or don't only come asking, but this is how we stand up for our people, for the city at large. So it'd be very, very helpful if all of you can in some way compile whatever work you are doing and send it to the chamber, and we will compile that and also share it with the government. Before I go further, I also want to tell you that most of the stuff that we tell you is something that we have picked up or the kind that we have done or what is our collective intelligence. I would request each and every one of you to take this only as a guidance and not as a dicta from CREDAI-MCHI. Whatever it is that we will put across to you as a document is what we have carried out, and that will again be treated only as a guidance. Now, very, very importantly, the first thing I want to share is that I'm so happy. We have all collaborated, even just today, on a new way of learning. We are 250 plus people on this chat, and we are all here to stand with each other. I've seen a lot of questions coming up. It really is nice. I would like this kind of participation to continue in the future. And towards that, I must say, it's not only hard times that should bring us together. It is at all times that we should be together. At hard times, we should be supportive and we should stand by each other. We've seen that the only people that have come across to our help is us. We are the only ones who will help ourselves. There is nobody else from the outside who's going to come. Over here, I want to state that the government is a slow process. CREDAI-MCHI has put across, CREDAI National has put across a whole host of points that we need to kind of, you know, be taken up for the industry. But I assure you, this is not something that's going to happen overnight. This is a slow process. We will have to be consistent. Each and every one of us must be having a reach at some point with some person who is in the corridors of power. I would say this is the time collectively as an industry, let's go out there and speak to them, even individually, repeating exactly what has been said. Our asks have got to be, they are enumerated well, they have been spelt out well. Please use the same language again and again and again to everyone that is there. Are we there?
Yeah, very okay. Much.
Sorry, I just saw something else on my screen. Another great thing that has happened recently is we've learned that the world can change overnight, like that, right? Every one of us had acquisition plans. Every one of us had March ending plans. Every one of us had, you know, new launch plans. Everything changed overnight. With the stroke of a virus, the whole world has come to a standstill. I think this is a great learning for all of us. Let us all be in our power at all points of time, knowing that tomorrow morning or tonight at 12 o'clock, like our Prime Minister said, the world can change around us. We need to be prepared at every stage of our working life that we can or we need to be able to stand up to any kind of adversity. So they say, you know, when you're driving, you drive at 60, 65% of your ability because others could be making a mistake. I'm saying when we are working, let us conserve a certain part of our ability, whether it is cash, whether it is just our people power, whether it is ourselves, and keep ourselves ready for what could possibly go wrong and at that point of time, stand out and stand up. Now, another important thing that you can do at this point of time is just keep in touch. Just keep in touch. Everybody is free. Everybody is sitting at home. Sab log aaram se baithe hain. Kisi ko phone utha ke kar lo. Aapka supplier ho. Aapka contractor ho. Aapke khud ke log ho. Internal teams ho. Unse aap baat kariye. Aapke customers ko reach out kariye. Aap jitno ko individually jante ho. Unko phone utha ke baat kijiye. Shayad aapko wo har cheez achhi nahi batayega. But uske man mein ye rahegi baat. कि आपने उसको फोन करके उसके सेहत के बारे में his health, his family, आपने उसके बारे में पूछा था and this is something that will give you a personal connect. देखिए आपकी रोज-रोज जिंदगी में ये भागा दौड़ी में ये होता नहीं है तो ये टाइम है आपको ये करने का आप अपने इंटरनल टीम्स से जिसके पास बहुत बड़ी-बड़ी टीम्स हैं 200 लोग से ज्यादा हैं मैं जानता हूं आप सबके नाम भी नहीं जानते होंगे बट ये सही टाइम है कि आप उनको एक वेबिनार पे लाएं Zoom को यूज करें एंड टॉक टू देम आप जितना जानते हो उतना उनसे शेयर करें उनको एक कॉन्फिडेंस दें जैसे हमने अभी-अभी आपको हमारी कॉन्फिडेंस बांटी है आप भी उनमें कॉन्फिडेंस बांटें ये गरीब लोग होते हैं दीस पीपल आर लुकिंग एट यू फॉर गाइडेंस दे आर लिसनिंग टू एवरीबॉडी इन द वर्ल्ड एंड गेटिंग कंफ्यूज्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ व्हाट्सएप जिसको कहते हैं UOW इससे इतने परेशान हो गए हैं वो जानते नहीं व्हाट इज राइट एंड रॉन्ग तो आपकी तरफ से आपके लीडर्स हो यू आर द लीडर ऑफ योर ओन ग्रुप प्लीज टॉक टू देम नाउ आई विल कम टू अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एंड दैट इज that you need to plan your startup strategy. Aaj se leke 7 din, 8 din mein, next Tuesday ko ye band pura hoga. Ek tarah se pura isliye hoga ki government will also need to give some breather time. Bahut sari stories chal rahi hai ki second lockdown aayega, shayad aayega. Lekin wo baad mein aayega. It will come after another 7, 8, 5, 6 days, whatever it is. Ye 4-5 din mein bhi, aap immediately aapke sare logon ko aise ek saath office mat bulana please plan your strategy what I'm saying is for the larger teams aapke agar choti teams hai to obviously you have no option jo work from home kar rahe hain unko bulana padega aap staggered time de sakte ho unko agar aapki choti team hai to kuch logon ko savere if it is possible call them early aur kuch logon ko sham ko late yes aapko zyada kaam karna padega in this period if you have to be around through the entire day you will have to take that extra step Very importantly, ये सब करने के पहले आपको आपकी offices को sanitize कराना पड़ेगा. Please get your offices sanitized by, take personal interest in this. आपको आपके लोगों के लिए जो health masks होते हैं, वो लाने पड़ेंगे. लोगों को office में जाके पहले थोड़ा दूर खड़े रख के सबको बोलना पड़ेगा. Social distancing will continue in the office. ये 21 दिन के बाद ये पूरी बीमारी गई नहीं है इट इज जस्ट अ वे द गवर्नमेंट हैज यूज्ड द टाइम टू बी एबल टू काइंड ऑफ फाइंड आउट व्हिच आर द हॉट स्पॉट्स और वो हॉट स्पॉट्स को कंटेन करने के लिए मेरी आपसे दरखास्त रहेगी इट इज माय रिक्वेस्ट टू ईच एंड वन ऑफ यू योर पीपल्स हेल्थ इज द सिंगल मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग फॉर यू यस यू पे देम अ सैलरी बट द सैलरी डजंट बाय देम इट इज ओनली अ वे फॉर यू टू शो दैट दे केयर प्लीज प्लान all your social distancing even in your office plan strategic time for people to come at various hours please buy those defogging machines or get them from your site your contractors always have them please get that done ask everybody to do simple basic hygiene stuff tell them that every hour they've got to wash their hands tell them something simple as left hand is for everything aap har cheez ko haath laga sakte hain left hand se अगर अपने चेहरे को अपनी आंख को अपने नाक को आप हाथ लगाते हो तो यूज द राइट हैंड ये बहुत सिंपल चीजें होती है बट पीपल डोंट नो पीपल मेक मिस्टेक्स पुट अप होल्डिंग और पुट अप स्मॉल प्लकार्ड्स अराउंड द ऑफिस आल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग एटसेट्रा आई डोंट वांट टू गो ऑन एंड ऑन आई जस्ट विश अस ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट वी आर द इंडस्ट्री दैट इज गोइंग टू बिल्ड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड बी द ट्रू वेल्थ क्रिएटर्स एंड टेक आवर राइट प्लेस इन द मार्केट्स टू कम प्लीज बी पेशेंट Please conserve cash. Please be transparent with your people and always do the right thing. With that, I hand it over to you, Pritam. And if there are any questions, please send them out to the person you want them to have answer.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone, for your advice to the members at large. I have a lot of questions on the chat, and I'm trying to group them. Fortunately, we have Mafatra ji also, and I think Rajni bhai also on the chat. And Deepak bhai has requested them to say a few words to our members. Though we have an individual session with our past presidents on the next Sunday, I will request Mafatra ji to unmute himself and say a few things. If Rajni bhai is there to also say a few things to our members.
Trupti, do the new tool.
If they're taking time, then I will go ahead so that they can join in at appropriate time.
I think so. Mute me over.
Radni bhai can say.
Yeah.
Thank you, Radni bhai.
Good morning to everybody. I think I must compliment the president and entire team for arranging this by taking 212 members on the this common platform. As regarding this present situation, my suggestion number one is we must put simple our demands with the government, but we should not pursue. Let everything should settle, and then we should pursue. And our effort number two, our efforts with the state government as well as with the central government should with the national CREDAI and CREDAI Maharashtra, so it will bring a very effective result. And as Boman, Nayan and Deepak, everybody has told, we should be positive and we should face these challenges. And I know after every challenge, we will come out very strongly. Thank you.
Thank you, Rajni bhai. I can see Mafatra ji on the chat now.
Yes. No, I mean, I thank all of you to organize this webinar, and this is the right time when we have interacted. As everyone has said about it, that times are challenging, unprecedented challenges come to our industry. In any case, we are suffering from the slowdown and various issues. What I strongly suggest, you know, that we, CREDAI and the other people, you know, make a one concise representation to the government, central government. Are keen about reviving this industry. This is what I had a talk with Gitambar. We should do a precise few points. We really will help the industry rather than going into the 100 points and 50 points and other details. We should have a coordinated efforts to make a simple presentation to the government to support. Without the support of the central government, it will be very difficult, one on the side of the financing, liquidity. Second is the generation of demand. These are the two major issues which only the government incentives and the government support handle the industry. In any case, rest everything Boman, Nayan and Deepak has already said, I will repeat. Times are challenging, but only the positive attitude can help us to overcome these things. And real estate is the real industry. It is not a bubble, you know. I mean, it's not the stock market where fees are all imaginary. Here it's a real asset. It has got its value and it has got an effort. So we are in the industry, which is really beneficial to the country. This has to be impressed upon the government, central government, so that, and the state government, wherever the state government comes into, because we are burdened with a lot of taxes, we are burdened with a lot of regulatory issues, high interest burden. So all concise presentations should be made and a coordinated effort should be done, so that we can achieve a result. Rather than going into a 100 points or 50 points, we will not be able to achieve results. I've seen some of the CREDAI representation, and we should make the precise representation. This is my humble submission to Nayan and Boman. Please take care of this part so that the government should come to the rescue of the industry. And the people, because it's the highest employer and government wants to, that's what I understand, that the government wants to protect construction industries for the benefit of the huge labor force. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mufadraji. Thank you for your advice. I'll start with the first question. The first question is from Ajay Nahar. He says, thank you to the MCHI team. With all the positivity, there should be an A plan, B plan, and a C plan in mind, given that there is going to be an indication of a staggered exit from the lockdown. His question is, what if the extension of the timeline of lockdown increases beyond the 14th of April to the bank repayment, to ongoing construction and payments of our contractor supply chain, will take time to stabilize? In case of rental, and a lot of people have asked questions about SRA rentals and redevelopment rentals, as to how we can, interest is one outgo, but even the rentals and to SRA in the redevelopment members is a big chunk of cash which goes out of our system every month. So we like the panel to address this.
Pritam, President, with you, okay, may I go ahead?
Yeah, please, please.
So Pritam, these are unprecedented times, like everybody has been mentioning. There is really no right and wrong answer. It just depends on the structure of your transaction with, I can speak about redevelopments largely. Redevelopments, if you've given a heavy corpus upfront, or you've given any other kind of emoluments, or you've paid a lot of rentals upfront, I think it is time to kind of pull back, conserve, talk to them. It's all by communication only. It has to be a joint exercise. I'm sure most people have spoken clearly, will understand the issue. Yes, they might be unreasonable. Certain number of them will be. But we all have our, you know, protocol to follow. As far as the slums are concerned, I don't think you have an option. I think every one of us would have put in at least a 3 to 6 month contingency plan with the slums. If that is the case, please continue making the payments. I'm sure it'll reap huge benefits later. And please talk to them even while making.
Boman, we can't hear you. I think something has gone wrong.
I'm done. I finished. Okay. Did you all hear me?
Yeah, last we could not hear.
No, I said if it's the slums, then we have to have a 3 to 6 month built-in contingency plan. I'm sure that is something that, you know, you'd have to pay, because those are the poorest of the poor in society. They have no other way to take care of themselves. Pay them. It will keep phenomenal returns for you. They will go out and be your campaigners in the future. Any other property that you're doing, they will support you. And I suggest you take care of them. Even your redevelopments, if you do not put heavy corpuses up front, etc., then you might want to continue paying them. It's short-term pain. It's whether it's at the most another month. It will not last forever. This day has to go. Otherwise, we will all be finished. Right? Take that into consideration and please make the payments. Done.
There is a question. I'm consolidating questions. One of the questions is, what should a regular businessman and a developer do in the first 1 month of the lockdown being lifted? What are the typical things that come to your mind from your wisdom that we should do? For one is to stagger our office timings and stuff like that. And also from a business point of view, what a lot of people are asking.
I tell you, Anuj Ranjan of Brookfield said, on a webinar the other day, he said, one of the first things that you do is please start taking this time now, build efficiency into your business. There are so many processes and systems that we kind of, you know, add on, so many people that we add on, which can not be a necessity for our businesses, given the size and scale of it. This might be the time to have one person to do 1.5 person's job. This might be the time to upgrade and work on technological changes that would allow you to be a lot more efficient. This might be the time to take a fine tooth comb and actually sit down with your leaders and go through each and every process that they feel is extra, and take care of it. Beyond that, all I can say is the general gyan would be, in the future, please learn that there will be difficulties and you need to hold a certain amount of cash as a contingency, as a conservation. Hold on to it. Don't get over ambitious. Learn from these mistakes. At this point of time, like I mentioned initially, this time it is only for survival. Please come through this time. You will have a lot to do in the future. Don't look at anything new. Don't suddenly think that you become, you know, maybe some of us are sitting on some cash and we suddenly get opportunistic and we try to go ahead and take 3-4 properties and, you know, squeeze the other person. Not the time. Try and conserve your cash for yourself because you're going to need it. The first people you care for are your internal people. They are your family. After that, your set of suppliers, contractors, pay them 5%, 10%. Tell them you stand with them or tell them to use their own balance sheets to raise money. Tell them you will support them. Be honest with them. Third is all our projects that we are doing. Take a call on which are the projects we should do, which are the projects we can hold back. Every governmental agency will support you, but it will take time. Till then, it is only you and us who can take care of ourselves. Let us share, let us be honest, and let us tell people exactly what it is. Communication is going to be the key.
Thank you for that.
I'd like to add 2 points into that. Number one, a cost of construction. We see, one thing is very clear, that the prices will remain stable. We don't need to panic as far as the prices are concerned. You will have customers coming and telling to you, main ye karunga, main wo karunga, mera itna price kam kar, wo kar. Please don't fall into the trap. Please, this is one time when we should not undercut each other. If I am having, I have a project at Vikroli, I speak to 3 other developers around, ask them, bhai tu kya bhav se bikta, main kya bhav se bikta hun. Hum usse niche nahi bechenge. Kyunki the moment ek aadmi ne bhi shuru kiya na undercut karne ko, aap samajh lo, कि पूरी मार्केट में सब यही बात करेंगे कि भाई हमें कम करना है, हमें कम करना है. दिस इज वन टाइम वेयर वी मस्ट स्टैंड फॉर्म फॉर द नेक्स्ट 6 मंथ्स. 3 महीने का तो वैसे भी इंटरेस्ट एंड मोरेटोरियम मिल गया है. क्या पता हमको आगे आगे भी और शायद मोरेटोरियम मिल सकता है. सो वी हैव टू सी दैट वी कीप आवर प्राइसेस स्टेबल. सेकंड पॉइंट इज ऑल आवर कंट्रोलेबल एक्सपेंसेस. बजट सी व्हिच आर द एक्सपेंसेस आई कैन रिड्यूस. I have already requested Nimish Ajmera and the procurement team that work out is how we can reduce our cost of construction by 5 to 10%. So, these are the 2 things that, you know, I would say from my side about what to do. And one more thing I want to tell you, the repo rate has been reduced by 0.75%. So, today the home loans are available at 7.95. If the government tomorrow comes out with further incentives, you may end up with a situation where you are able to offer a home loan at 6.95 or 7%. And that coupled with ke real estate sahi hai, will get the demand back going. I'm done.
Thank you, Nayan bhai. There have been a lot of queries from our members about can the chamber start some marketing activity at the likes of how the mutual fund sahi hai campaign has been going on. The first point that I like to add is that it's a very expensive campaign. It is being contributed by all members of the mutual fund industry to come up with an industry-wide campaign like that. And thereby, our national CREDAI has taken up an initiative. And Dhaval Ajmera informs us that CREDAI National Youth Wing is working on doing some PR and marketing activity for positive news for real estate. Similarly, on the lines of the mutual fund industry, which says real estate achha hai. Post the lockdown, this will be activated and we will see some action on that. So, that is what the CREDAI National is doing. Vinita Dalal, one of our members from Rustamji, is also adding that banks and RBI are in discussion for extending the restructuring with the additional 2 years need for existing need of funding to existing borrowers. Also, all cases which were NPA or SMA. SMA is whoever is more than 30 days interest not paid or principal not paid. On December 2019, they are revising the classification of NPA from 90 days to 180 days so that there is a breather for those cases also. This is all work in progress. So this is not to be discussed outside, but this is a lot of information which is going, discussions which are going on with the Finance Ministry, RBI and the banks through the IBA. So we will be hearing from the Finance Ministry or the RBI in the next 10 to 15 days about these two. So there is going to be some more relief that is going to come. I can see one hand up. 1 minute. I'll just finish, sir. Vivo 1819. I'll just give you one. There are other questions as to once the lockdown is opened. The question is, sir, what will happen if the workers start to migrate back, the balance workers in Mumbai start to migrate back to their villages? How do we contain that? Can we speak to the state government or someone? There's a question from one of our members. That it's a little unique question, so I thought I'll ask that.
So, just let me tell you what exactly. I think I sent out Aditya Thackeray's talk yesterday. State borders aren't going to be opened in a hurry unless you are in one of the essential services for transportation, etc. State border boundaries are not going to be opened up. These people will have to control themselves. Though I've seen that trains have started bookings again, I'm not too sure. So, that is my limited point. But no, that's a very big issue today. We will have to start thinking about it. And all of us will need to give assurance to our laborers who are already there. Okay, you please be here till 15th of June. Anyhow, you need to, because especially those people who are having basements, you know, they are in a very, very critical position. Some of them may not have even done shore piling also. So it's very critical, you know, that on that count, Boman, we may need to tell Aditya Thackeray and others, okay, sir, at least up to 10th of June, you know, we should not have these workers leaving.
Okay. Thank you, Nayan Bhai. There's a question from one Mr. Rakesh. What is the future of redevelopment of cooperative housing societies, that is private redevelopment? Because premiums are very high, permissible FSI is lesser than MADA and SRA, and there is less profitability than in a MADA or SRA project. Are there any plans to reduce the ready reckoner rate and increase the permissible FSI? And what is the future of self-development, he asks. Any one of the panel members can take this question.
Well, you know, I do a society redevelopment. I would say that the society redevelopment in any case was at a pause and a mute mode in the last 2 to 3 years. Whatever projects that you are seeing of society redevelopment that are happening are old commitments which we has made. I don't think so for the next 1 year. I mean, anywhere from between 6 months to 1 year, we will be able to look at, redevelopment becoming more viable unless and until government really kind of gives some sort of an equal incentive to society redevelopment on the lines of what they're giving to MADA, SRA, and 33-7 about old and redevelopment of old and dilapidated buildings. So all this needs to fall in line and it will take its own time. The government is seized about it, you know, as of now. So that's all, you know, I can say.
Okay. The next question is, what about servicing unsecured loan interest? And does anyone on the panel want to take that question? Baman, do you want to come in and take that question? What is the view on servicing unsecured loan interest?
So very simply, you know, Pritam, there is no right answer. This is a more personal, you know, whoever you're taking private finance from is a relationship. I think it depends on the length and the breadth of the relationship going forward that you want to keep and accordingly deal with the people. You can always ask for a pushback in terms of when the interest will be paid. I'm sure that most people will not mind. But if they are smaller families, let's say you've collected money at, you know, from very, very many small families whose entire household depends on it, please treat them with the same respect that you treat, you know, your class 4 employees, where they literally survive on this. Be human. Do the right thing. There really is no right answer. If Deepak wants to take a go at it or Nayan wants to take a go at this. Well, I will be very honest that all your private loans, which are below, say, 25 lakhs, 50 lakhs, you know, and they depend on interest, we must see to it that we give them interest because unka ghar unki wajah se chalta hai. Most of the private loan that we all have, they have been remaining there. They are with us from last 5 years, 10 years, 15 years. They are family friends of ours or relatives and everything. So as far as private loan is concerned, I think I'm very clear that we must give them interest on time.
Thank you. there is also a rejoinder from Dhaval Admiras. He feels that though National CREDAI is going to come up with a campaign, there is a big need for MMR to also have its own campaign, which will be more effective for our real estate sales. So, if there is all the city unit presidents have the same view, if they can connect with the president, then we can look at an option where we can pull in some funds, because funds is a big thing, because for marketing, you know, we require a lot of money as a unit, and then we can come up with a campaign through an agency if the president and the secretariat feel so. So that is something that is coming up. There are a lot of questions on what happened. My NBFC is not letting me the moratorium. Someone has said Nippon is not letting me because they are SEBI governed. There are a lot of questions, but these are something which we have already represented to RBI as well as to their respective to SEBI also we have written. You will have to take it up individually with them, saying that you know, if RBI is has given a diktat, though you are not covered, you are under SEBI, you are requested to do so. There's also the NBFCs have written to the RBI that they have taken money from the banks. So if they give a moratorium to their customers like us or to the home loan customers, then how will they service their interest to the banks? So that question and answer session between RBI and NBFCs is going on. But we have to write to them and insist that since RBI has written and NBFC is under the RBI or HFC, you are requested to give us the moratorium if you wish to take the moratorium. There are a lot of other questions with about vendors and stuff like that. I will...
Pritham sir, there is one question.
Yeah, I think 50 is some questions which I come on writing, you can take them up.
Yes, what about rents in big SRA projects? Cash flow will be adversely affected.
We have taken that question.
Okay.
Next question.
Most of the questions are already. Please request authorities like CIDCO and BMC to fast track proposals to cover up the list time. I'm just reading out so we can go through all of them. What is the status of CRC plan for Maharashtra area?
I think that's a question we'll keep for later. This is about right now COVID and COVID related issues. There are a lot of issues with related to real estate, whether CRZ, whether it is environmental clearance, civil aviation. We'll leave them for another time.
Okay.
For now, we'll stick to our questions related to our business affected by COVID.
What measures to be taken on site and sales? So should people start making use of the digital marketing that they're doing? Should people start the sales part of it?
So,
Pritam, shall I just take that?
Yes, please.
So, very clearly, digital marketing is something that, you know, most companies need to focus on even more now than they have done before. This is a great time for your salespeople to get across, pick up the phone and talk to people individually. Of course, please train them. Don't just tell them to go cold into a call and tell them, "Haja, flat lena hai kya type, we're giving a discount." I think it's more about what leads you've generated in the past, whatever you've kind of interacted with in the past. Those you got to go deeper and try to kind of mine that data only. And wherever there are relationships built, please use those relationships going forward. I think this is also a great time to re-engage with your first buyer, who's your broker. I mean, he's very, very important today. It is important that you kind of communicate with him. I think as a company, come up with a policy where you give some kind of an assurance to people with regards to prices and say that this price, if we should kind of, for whatever reason, bring it down, we will go ahead and kind of compensate you, establish that trust. And I think one of your questions was also with regards to on-site preparation. I think on-site preparation, please, every one of you have a thermal gun, which is a contactless thermal gun. Provide masks to your people while they are working. Provide gloves to people. You should not only seem to be doing the right thing, you should be doing the right thing at all points of time. Please buy hand sanitizers, buy the bulk. Please teach people how to use them. One of the key points is tell people before they start to smoke or something, they should not be using a hand sanitizer. Otherwise, they could, you know, be grievously injured. These are the kind of things that use your safety officers. Or then if you wish, we will at CREDAI-MCHI drop an entire do-don'ts for sites, offices, and send it across to you shortly. Uh, Pritam, two things. I would also request at some point of time you and Dharmesh to please inform all our members about the web series that we are going to have this week, number one. But before that, I want to ask, request for the members that are you guys ready to contribute to a fund that we can make for to contribute to on the issue of real estate sahi hai, you know. Can I get a commitment from you that, okay, 0.25% or 0.5% or whatever may be your turnover, nobody wants to ask you, but can this be a self-imposed discipline that, you know, we can have you on your own contributing, you know, coming forth? And, you know, so, but because if we get a right budget, you know, then we can really make a big change over here. So what is the response? And I want you all guys to be very, very frank about it, you know. Can people reply on the chat, you know, whether they agree, they don't agree, or whatever it is, you know.
So
I'll request Dharmesh bhai to give some idea about the next 10 days of webinars that we are organizing.
Just adding to what Nayan was saying, some time back, we had invited the top four agencies of the country, and we have probably, you know, full detailed representations from the top four agencies of the country on something like real estate sahi hai. Obviously, we have to again engage with them and tweak it to today's requirement. But it is something really doable, and I think it is very, very important that real estate has a voice as real estate and not as, you know, developers. All of us have developer voices today, but as an industry, we should have a strong campaign. And as Nayan suggested, if everybody is willing to come together, it's brilliant, and today's time can be pushed ahead. Going forward, two parts. One, obviously, we'll brief you on what is planned for the next 10 days. What very importantly we would want to do is, along with that, also have your suggestions on what topics you would want to be taken up. So, we will give you a quick rundown on whatever is planned for the next 7-8 days. And please, on the chat, write back to us on any other topics that you would want, you know, to be taken up. So, this is all about interacting and learning from each other. So, we'd love to have your suggestions. So, Pritam, if you can just quickly run everybody through, you know, what has been planned for the next 7 days, and then we'll take it from there.
I will just say from my memory, I don't have it readily. Tomorrow, we have a session with Rajiv Sabarwal of Tata Capital and Sunil Ramchandani of ICICI at 11 o'clock tomorrow. So, most of the webinars, except where we say this on another time, is going to be between 11 and 12. Day after tomorrow, we have the entire Anarok team led by Mr. Anuj Puri and his research, Prashant Thakur and Shobhit Agarwal, on video talking about the real estate industry and all the other aspects of the COVID-related sales and stuff like that. On Thursday, we are requesting our senior members from CREDAI National, Gitambar Ji, our current president, Dada, Satish Magar Ji, and anyone else, Jakshay, along with our senior management of MCHI, to come on, you know, online on Zoom and address a similar session to all our members so that we get a national perspective and
both Gitambar and Satish Dada have already confirmed, and we are reaching out to Irfan also. So
Superb. So we can get a national perspective of what's happening in other states and other regions of the country, and how are they coping up and what are their plans. So it'll be a very, very informative session. On Friday, we have a very interesting guest from McKinsey. McKinsey is one of the largest consulting and one of the best consulting companies in the world. We have Subbu Narayan Swamy, who is the managing partner of real estate infrastructure, who is going to talk to us about the views of from an outside perspective, how the business, how the economy, how other countries have coped with this, and what China has done, what other people have done to come out and fight this void. So it's going to be a very, very interesting session that will be on Friday. On Saturday, we have kept a session on digital marketing. A lot of questions have come here are about how do we start marketing our products again. Since there is going to be a huge fear of getting out for our customers, digital marketing is going to become very important. So there's a session by the founder, co-founder of Togglehead, who's a very good faculty of Remy also, who's going to come on board on Saturday and take a session on digital marketing. On Sunday, we have...
Pritam, if you could just pause, I would love to have everybody's suggestion whether one day in a week would want a non-realistic topic to be taken up. General motivation, health, wellness, just general learning. Whether you would want one day in a week non-realistic to be taken up, please send us your suggestions on that as well. Sorry, Pritam, we can continue.
On Sunday, we will have the benefit of the more than 200 years of experience, because we are requesting our past presidents to address all of us so that they can give their view of how they see the future and how do we deal with the situation that we are in currently. On Monday, this is only one thing which is not confirmed, is on Monday, we are requesting one of the China desks of either JLL or CBRE to give us a presentation of how China went into the lockdown and how it has come out and how business has come back, and see if we can get some best practices from the China desk of JLL or CBRE. On Tuesday, we have kept a slot, and not that they are governed by it. We are requesting Honorable Municipal Commissioner and Honorable Chief Secretary, one of them, to come on board. The timing is not going to be as per us, whenever they give us a time. In fact, if they give us a time of any other day also, we at short notice be writing to you to come on board so that we can hear their views of what representations we have made and what they need from us in the next 3 to 6 months. So that's a very interesting session. We are going to contact them today or tomorrow and request their presence on the Zoom. On Wednesday next week, we have a final session with our legal experts from Dhaval Vasanji. So Dhaval Vasanji himself and Sajid Suwarna of DSK Legal will be addressing all legal queries. We have signed so many contracts. There are so many force majeure questions that have come up. There are so many contracts which will have to be renegotiated. So there are a lot of questions which we have legally. We are requesting two of our best real estate lawyers to help our members with that. So that will be on Wednesday next week. So we have planned about 10 days. Let's see how this goes. It all depends upon the feedback and the number of people that come on this Zoom call. If there's an overwhelming response, we'll be happy to organize more webinars. And also Tuesday, Wednesday is the first day supposedly of the opening up of the lockdown, if it gets opened up, even if it does partially. So after that, we have not planned anything. It will all depend upon the feedback we get from our members. The other thing is that a lot of questions have come up. I'll just quickly ask some of them. Some of them are just rhetorical questions. Whenever RBI reduces the repo rate, NBFC should pass it on automatically. We already asked for this request for the rate to be not linked to the bank SLR. We have asked them to be linked to the repo rate so that we get a benefit immediately, our customers get a benefit immediately. There's been an overwhelming response from members for contribution of the marketing fund. So President, Secretary, there has been an overwhelming response. There should be a fixed amount from everyone and a corpus should be formed so that it can benefit the entire MMR region for marketing real estate SAIA campaign.
If that is the case, then probably one of these days at least we can give a quick sort of overview of what can be done, and if people are willing to, it's something we should clearly come up with a plan.
Yeah, sure.
Jaideep Bhai is asking, how do we log on to this webinar? So we will be reminding you through our MCHI 1, 2, 3 chats, also through various means about these webinars. Every webinar is at 11 to 12. Login details will remain the same, but if there is a change in timing or anything else. So the one on Friday is at 10 o'clock or 1 o'clock. It's not at 11 o'clock because the gentleman is not free. The McKinsey gentleman is not free at 11 o'clock. So it may be at 10 or 1. We'll let you know. But Jaideep Bhai, these are common logins and you'll be given 4 reminders to the previous day to on the day of the webinar so that you'll get sufficient notice to come in and log on. It will be a Zoom call always. Yeah. There are a lot of requests, GST requests, MCGM, all requests are on board and they are being pursued like the way they have been in the past.
Somebody has asked a question, how do you focus on association work along with your businesses? I think clearly association work is the best learning for your own business as well. So what you will realize is that you learn more and give less when you do association work. So everybody get involved and it's the best learning and best thing you can do for yourself and your business as well.
We are done with the questions on the panel here. I saw a gentleman, VO1819, put up his hand sometime back. Can you unmute yourself and ask your question, sir, if it's anything different from the ones we have already answered? Would you like to say something? VO1819. The gentleman who put up his hand. Yeah, you unmute yourself. You can talk, sir. Okay, does anyone else want to ask a question? You can put up your hand. There's also an option of sending me a chat and I can ask that gentleman a question. I'm trying to see. President Secretary, we've got a lot of compliments for the webinar series that we've organized. Thank you, sir, for the permission and for doing this. Dharmesh Bhai, thank you for your idea.
Thank you.
Does anyone want to ask questions? I'm going to go through all my screens to see if anyone's hands are up. So I'll announce their names. Does anyone want to ask a question? I can see Sanjay Vora putting up his hand.
Thank you, Pritam. First of all, let me thank everybody for such a wonderful webinar. My question is that we have placed a lot of orders from China, which were on hold during this lockdown period. Now, do we have any inputs on the government policies that are going to come up regarding material coming from China?
I think we'll have to address that issue. Currently, currently we really have not addressed that particular issue, to be very honest with you. Can I request you to please make a kind of a representation for us and send it to us so that we can, take it up with CREDAI National and, represent it with whatever suggestions you have.
Thank you, Nayan. I'll definitely send a mail across. Thank you. Yeah.
Hi.
Pritam, one thing, he has been doing phenomenal work for research, for gathering the data, and for also setting the tone of real estate Sahi Hai. Some of the press coverage that we got in Money Control and all the papers, it was his background work that he did. So that way, I think before we wind up, we need to have some kind of a budget made up for real estate Sahi Hai. And I would request the members that whatever budget or you may have in mind, you may call up Boman, Deepak, myself, or Pritam, or Dhaval, or anybody, and please tell privately, as to what kind of a figure do you have in mind. Because the better the budget, the more it is going to help. See, all of us put together today, we'll have at least 2 crore square feet of work going on. I mean, I'm just giving a wild number. At least 2 crore square feet between the 250 developers that we have right now, at least I feel so. And imagine, even if we are able to maintain the price, what difference will it make? Or even if you are able, if it leads to 10% discount that you have to give if we are not united, so see the loss that can come to us. So I would request that please call up Bandish or Deepak or Boman or anybody in our core committee, and tell them whatever budget that you may have in mind.
Nayan bhai, we'll do that. We will also make a form so that we can get everyone's response from the unit presidents.
Yes.
I have a question from Sachin Mirani from Thane. He's asking the panel, can we request the state government to let us start the work at site with proper care to be taken?
It's a very good suggestion.
I think so.
Yes, I think we'll do that post 15th. Yeah, 15th. Yeah, and post. Please start. Sachin, I would advise you to first start focusing on your site, because you know you'll need to do a lot of on-site activities like cleanliness, etc., putting up those social distancing, putting up proper boards everywhere to tell people how to work. We will be preparing something and sending it across. Please share that with all your sites also.
Thank you.
With that, guys, thank you very much. Great session. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Bye.
Thank you for joining
us. Bye, everybody.
Thank you. Bye.